we have the distribution, and in this we have range. That is, the x has range, frequency is like that only, which we already discussed in the previous sections. So here we have a range. So how to solve this, or how to find out the average or mean? So here we have the distribution of total household expenditure in rupees of manual workers of a city, and we need to find out the average expenditure in rupees per household. So what we will do, just because there are certain questions which are like this only, so you need to understand it very carefully. This is the class interval which is given in the question. We cannot take this one or this one, which one we will take, but there is a class interval. So for that we take the mid value, that is, we take this first value 100, we take another value, that is this is the lower limit, this is the upper limit, and we add the lower and upper limit and we divide it by 2. So 100 plus 150 is 250. When we divide it by 2, we get 125. So this is our number. Similarly with this one, we add these two and write it here. All of these, all, you know, column members will do like this. Now we will assume a mean. That is, if we assume 275, you can take 325 also. But if you assume 275, then you have to subtract all the values of this column with 275. That is, 125 minus 275. That would be minus 150. 175 minus 275, that would be minus 100, like this. So all these you have to subtract till here from 275. Now write it here. Now we need, these numbers are still big, so we need to, because we are sorting, or you can say we are trying to solve it using the shortcut method. These values have to be divided by the class interval. What is the class interval? See, this is a class, so it is 100 and 150. So we subtract the upper limit, that is the lower limit from upper limit. So u minus l will do 150 minus 100. That is, our h or class interval is 50. So we'll divide this by 50. We'll divide this by 50. So we'll divide all these values by 50. All these values. So what do we get? This column. Now we are ready for the multiplication with the frequency. Now we have got this column, these values are, we can handle these values. So now this is frequency. We'll multiply this, minus 3 into 24, minus 2 into 40, minus 1 into 33, these all are given here. And then we get this column. Now we add it, we add all the value, we get minus 35. What we'll do here is, this is sigma, this is sigma fi ui. So what we will do, sigma fi ui by sigma f, that is minus 35 by 200. Then we have to multiply it with the class interval. What is the class interval, or what was the class interval? 50. And we have to add it with the assumed mean, 275. So this will be our answer, which will come 266.25. So now you understood how to do this. We'll just if the questions are like this, we'll just pass by, and wherever it has some, you know, different thing, then we'll discuss. So here the class interval is 0 to 2, 2 to 4. So a survey was conducted by a group of students as a part of their environmental awareness program, in which they collected these data regarding the number of plants in certain households in a locality. Find the mean number of plants per house. So this is not 200, this is 20. Now just write this here in first column, this in the second column. Now what we can do here is, because this is a class interval, we cannot take this one or this one, we have to take the mid value. So 0 plus 2 by 2, that is 1, 2 plus 4 by 2, like 3, so all these will come. Frequency, that is number of houses are given, just multiply 1 with 1, you get 1. So all these multiplication corresponding, this column and this column corresponding value you multiply, and you get these values. Add this 162, divide by 20. So we have not taken any assumed mean, the class interval is also not employed. So this 162 by 20 is the answer. This is the simple method. Here we have a distribution of daily wages of worker of a factory. Now we need to find the mean daily wages of the workers of the factory by using appropriate method. So what will be the appropriate method? We have to see the numbers which are coming. If they are large, then we'll go to the second method. Then we go to the shortcut, last method. That is, we need to see the numbers. So these are the, this you write in the first column, this you write in the second column, then you just add these two and divide by 2, so you get, see, 120 by 100, 120 plus 100, that is 220 by 100 is 110. So you add upper limit and lower limit, divide it by 2. So all these values will come. Now you assume a value as an assumed mean. So this is 150. So you subtract all these values with 150, all the values by 150. You get this. Now still these numbers are bigger. So we'll divide it by the class interval. What is the class interval? 120 minus 100, 140 minus 120, that is 20. So divide all these by 20 and write it here. This is the column. Frequency you can write it, right? Now you multiply. This is 16. This is 14, this is 14. So this is 14. You just multiply these two. 2 minus 2 into 12 and minus 1 into 14 like this. And just add this. This will come to be minus 12. Minus 12. So minus 12. This is minus 12. And what is the sum of this? This is 50. So this is 50. 50. Multiply by the class interval, which is 20. So this is 20. Add it with the assumed mean, that which was 150. So 145.2 will come. 30 women are examined in a hospital by a doctor, and the number of heartbeats per minute recorded and summarized as follows. Find the mean heartbeats per minute of these women choosing a suitable method. So these are given, so just make the table and first write this in first column, this in second column. Now we'll just add these two, divide by 2. Okay, 65 plus 68 by 2, 66.5. 68 plus 71 by 2, that is 69.5. Now you assume the mean, that is 75.5. You take any of these value, this one or this one or this one, the value will come same. So now just subtract all these values by 75.5. So you get this. Now you have a class interval, 68 minus 65 is 3. So what do you get? When you divide it by 3, you get this. Now multiply these two. Means minus 9 into minus 3, minus 6 into minus 2, like this. So this will come. Okay. Then what you have to do, add this. So it will come to be 4. So 4 divided by what is your sigma f, that is frequency addition, which is this one. This will come to be 30. This is not 3, this is 30 actually. Okay. So 30 multiplied with by the class interval, which is h, which is 3. Now you add this assumed mean. So this 75.9 will be the answer. Find the mean of each of the following frequency distribution. Again, same thing, 0 and 6, 6 and 12. So just add them, divide by 2. Then take this assumed mean, subtract all these values by minus 15. Now divide by the class interval, 6 minus 0 is 6. So divide all the values by 6. You get this line or this column. Multiply it with the frequency which is given in the question. And once multiplied, add these. So this will come as 3. The n is 40. Then multiply it with the class interval h, which is 12 minus 6 is 6. Then add it with the assumed mean. What was the assumed mean? 50. So this will come as 15.45. Now the class intervals are given. Frequency is given. Same thing. Just add these two. Divide by 2. Now take this assumed mean as 100. You can take 120 also. Now subtract each value by 100. Now divide by the class interval, which is 70 minus 50, 20. So you get this line, this column, and again you have this column fi. Now multiply this column with this column, each the corresponding values. You get fi ui as this one. Now add these, you will get 61. Sigma f is this sigma f. This one will be 18, 12, all these will be 100. Multiplied with h, that is 70 minus 50, that is 20. Add it with the assumed mean, which is 100. So this will come as 112.2. Again, the class interval is given, frequency is given, same thing, just add upper limit and lower limit, divide by 2. Now take the assumed mean, subtract each value with 20, that is 4 minus 20, minus 60, like this. Then you divide it by the class interval, 8 minus 0 is class interval, h is 8. So you get this column. Now frequency is also there, now multiply, each element you multiply, you get this one. Add this, you get 7. So 7 divided by 40, 40 is what? Sigma f, that is 40. What is the class interval, which is 8 minus 0, 8. Now add it with the assumed mean, 20. So you get 21.4. Again, same thing. Add these two here and divide by 2. Then take this as the assumed mean. subtract all the values of this column with 15, you get this. Now take the class interval, which is 6 minus 0, 6, divide each and every value of this column by 6. So you get this column, frequency is already there, multiply corresponding element, this with this, this with this, like this. So you get this column, add all these, you get a particular number. Now this is 5. What is sigma f? This is sigma fi ui. This is 40. Multiplied with the class interval, that is 6. Added with the assumed mean, which is 50. So 50. So you get 15.75. Same thing. We have these as class interval, add these two, divide by 2. So you get 5. Like all these, all columns you have to do, take the assumed mean as 25, subtract all the values with 25. All of these. Now divide all the values of this column by the class interval, which is 20 minus 10, 10. Divide by 10. So you get this. Frequency just write in this column. Multiply the corresponding element like this. Multiply these two and here. Add this, you get 8. 8 by this sigma f, that is 60. Now multiply it with the this class interval, which is 10. So this is 10. Add it with the assumed mean, 25. So what do you get? 26.333. Now class interval frequency, again, same thing you are going to do, 0 to 8, 8 to 16, so add these two, divide by 2, you get this. Take the assumed mean as 20, subtract each value by 20, you get this column. Now divide each and every element of this by 8, which, because the class interval h is 8. You get this column, you already have this frequency, so multiply corresponding element of this column, you get this column. Add all these. So you get a value which is 5. So 5 divided by sigma f, which is this one, 40. Multiply by the class interval, which is 8. Add it with the assumed mean, which is 20. So this will come to be 21. Same thing we'll do here. We have a column. So we'll add these two, upper limit, lower limit, and divide by 2. So you get this column by u plus l by 2. Now take the assume mean as 20, subtract 20, and now this column has to be divided by the class interval, 8 minus 0, that is h is 8. So divide by 8, you get this column, frequency is already there. Okay, frequency is not this, this is 5, 6, 4, 3, 2. Multiply the corresponding columns, corresponding value of the columns, you get fi ui as this one. Add all these, sigma fi ui, that is minus 9, minus 9 by this sigma f is 20. Class interval is 8, assume mean was 20. So this will be your answer. So class interval is this one. So just add these two, divide by 2, you get this column. Now subtract with the assumed mean taken as 60. You can take 80 also, it doesn't matter. So 60. Now subtract each element by 60. You get this column. Now divide the column by 30 minus 10, that is 20. So each and every element you have to divide by 20, you get this column. This column is already there, frequency, now multiply the corresponding elements. You get FIUI. Now sigma FIUI is addition of this. You get 40. Now sigma F is 50, so you 50. Multiplied by H, this is 50. Multiplied by H, H is what? 30 minus 10, that is 20. And what is the assumed mean? 60. So this is 65.6. Same thing, class interval, so you just have to add these two, divide by 2. You get 30, like this, all you have to do for this for whole column. Then you subtract with the assumed mean. Take 50 as assumed mean. So subtract each element by 50. So you get this column. Now just divide this by the range, or you can say the class interval. So 35 minus 25, h is 10. Divide each and every element of this column by 10. So you get this and this one. This one, right? Now f, frequency will write, and now multiply each corresponding element of these two columns, you get this, add this, you will get as minus 2, and sigma f is 40, multiply by h, which is 10, add the assumed mean, 50, you will get it as 49.5. Now here, you have to add these two, divide by 2, so you get 27, add 2, divide by 2, you get 32. Now, you will take the assumed mean, say 42. Subtract each element of this column with 52, you will get this column. Now divide each and every element by the class difference, that is the h range, 29 minus 25, that is, you have to count it, that will be 5. Divide by 5, you get this column. Now frequency, just write this as a column, multiply corresponding element, add all these values of this column, you get this sigma fi ui. So this is minus 79, sigma f is 70, multiply by the class interval, that is 5, added with the assumed mean 42. So this is what you get, 36.357. Here also same thing you are going to do, but the thing is calculate mean using all suitable methods. So the basic method is what? Class interval is given, we have to find out the mid value. So 1 plus 4 by 2, 2.5, 4 plus 9 by 2, like this. Okay, this column will come. Now what you are going to do, frequency is already there, so we will not do anything because this is the direct method. Just multiply this value with this value and write it here. Will not take any assumed value, will not divide it by any class interval. Just multiply this column with this column and add this. This 48 by 64 will be 13.25. Now we'll use the assumed mean method. So how do we do it? Again, same thing. These are the upper limit, lower limit. Just add them, divide by 2. Now, so take this as the assumed mean. Say you take 6.5. Okay, let the assumed mean be 6.5. This is 6.5. This is 6.5. Now subtract 2.5 minus 6.5. You get minus 4, like this. Now frequency is already there, so multiply these two, and just add the column, this column. You get 432. Now 432 is this one, 64 is the sigma f, added with 6.5. You get 13.25 in both the cases. The weekly observation on cost of living index in a certain city of the year 2004-2005 are given below. Compute the weekly cost of living index. So what we have the class interval. So we have to add these two, divide by 2. So we get this one, right? After this, we have to take a value which is assumed mean, say 1650. Subtract each value of this column by 1650. So this is 1650 subtracting. Now what is the class interval? 1500 minus 1400, that is 100. So divide all values here by 100. You get this one. Frequency is already there. Multiply these two, write it here. Multiply these two, write it here likewise. Now add this, you get 7. Sigma f is 52. So 7 by 52, what is h? 100. Multiply by h and add it with the assumed mean, 1650. So this will come as 1663.46. The following table shows the marks scored by 140 students in an examination of a certain paper. Calculate the average marks by using all the three methods. So we will use the direct method, assumed mean, deviation and shortcut method. The first method is simple. You just have to add these two, divide by 2, so you get the x value, that is mid value. Frequency is already there, multiply these two columns, corresponding value, write it here. Add all these, 3620, sigma f is 140, 3620 by 140, that is 25.857, this is the direct method. Now we'll use the assumed mean method. Now same thing we'll do, we'll add these two, divide by 2, so we get x. Now take an assumed mean, that is 25. Subtract 5 by 25 like this. So all you have to multiply this column by 25, you get this one. Now you don't have to divide it by the class interval. What you have to do here is simply multiply these two, write it here, add all these. 120 by 140, so 120 by 140 plus the assumed mean, which is 25, you get the same answer, 25.857. Now we'll use the shortcut method. Same thing we'll do, we'll find mid value. Now we'll take this 25, till here the method is same. So subtract the value by each value by 25, you get this column. Now what we'll do, we'll divide it by what? H, that is the class interval. 10 minus 0 is 10. So divide each and every value of this column by 10. So you get this one. The frequency is already there. Multiply the corresponding value, write it here, add it. You get 12 by 140 into 10, which is class interval, plus 25, which is assumed mean. So this is 25.857. So all these three methods, what do you get? You get same value, 25.857. The mean of the following frequency distribution is 62.8 and the sum of all the frequencies is 50. So sigma, that is 5 f1, 10 f2, 7, 8. If you add them, this will come to be 50. Compute the missing frequency f1 and f2. So we'll do it by the normal method. Okay. So we have class interval, mid value is this, add these two, divide by 2. Now frequency is given here, but 2 are missing. Now multiply these two, 5 into 10, 30 into f1, write it here. 50 into 10, 500, 70 into f2, 70 f2, 90 into 7, 630, and 110 into 8, that is 880. Add all these. You get 30 f1 plus 70 f2, plus 2060, and this is 50. What is this 50? 50 is C, 5 plus F1 plus 10 plus F2 plus 7 plus 8. This is 50. So F1 plus F2 will become 20. Multiply both sides by this 3. So you get one equation as 3F1 plus 3F2 equal to 60. Now the second thing is you are given the mean. So mean is what? This sigma Fi Xi by sigma Fi. So this whole divided by 50 is given as 62.8. Now take 50 here and you have 30 F1 plus 70 F2 as 1080. Now divide both sides by 10. So 3F1 plus 7F2 equal to 108. So this is our first equation. This is our second equation. We need to solve this. When we solve this, F1 will come as 8, F2 will come as 12. I hope you'll be able to solve this this equation. Okay, this is a linear equation. Next is, this is the following distribution shows the daily pocket allowance given to the children of a multi-story building. The average pocket allowance is 18. So the mean is also given. Find out the missing frequency. So here what we will do here is 11 plus 13 by 2. 13 plus 15 by 2. So all these column will be this plus this, upper and lower by, lower and upper by, plus lower plus upper by 2. The frequency is given. So multiply these two, 20 into 7, 14 into 6. This is not known. So let it be x. So this will come as 20x. When you add all these, you'll get 752 plus 20x. And this will be 44 plus x. All these will be 44 and this will be x. Now 752 plus 20x by 44 plus x is what? Is mean, which is given as 18. So 18, now multiply 18 with 44 plus x. Solve for x, x will be 20. So this value is 20. If the mean of the following distribution is 27, find the value of p. This p we have to find out. See, 0 plus 10 by 2, 10 plus 20 by 2, all this you write, mean value you have to write. Now the frequency you write 8, p, 12, 13, 16. Multiply this. 5 to 8, 40. 5, 15 into p, 152. Likewise. Now add this. You will get 1, 2, 4, 5 plus 15 p. This frequency, when you add, only p will remain. Otherwise, 8 plus 12 plus 13 plus 16 will be 43. Now 1 to 4, 5 plus 15 p by 43 plus p is what? It is the mean. Mean is given as 27. Equate it with 27. Solve for p. P will be 7. Right? In the retail market, fruit vendors were selling mangoes kept in packing boxes. Three boxes contain varying number of mangoes. The following was the distribution of mangoes according to the number of boxes. So this is 50-52. If you see that this is 50-52, but this starts from 53. So what about 52 till 53? There is no data, right? Here also 55 and 56. So where is 55 and what is the content between 55 and 56? So what we have to do here is, when this kind of observation is there or data is there, you have to subtract half from this and add half to this. Subtract 50 minus 0.5 will be 49.5 and 52 plus 0.5 is 52.5. You have to do with all the value like this one. 62 minus 0.5 is 61.5 and 64 plus 0.5 is 64.5. Okay. Now frequency you can write it here. Let us find out the mid value. So you just have to add these two and divide by 2. Add these two, divide by 2. So this will come. Now you have to take an assume mean. So you can take the assume mean, say as 57. This is 57. 51 minus 57, 54 minus 57, 57 minus 57, 60 minus 57 and 63 minus 57. So this column will come. Now what is the range? That is, what is the difference? Okay. Say 52.5 minus 49.5. What will come? 0. This is 3. So you have to divide it by 3. This is not 10. This is 3. So minus 6 by 3, minus 3 by 3. All these you have to divide by 3. So what do you get? This column. Now multiply the corresponding column, you get FIUI. Now add this. This is sigma FIUI. So this will come as, say this will come as a, I'll just add it. This will be minus 30 plus minus 110. This will be minus 140. This will be 115 and 50. 165. 165 minus 140 is minus 25. So this will be minus, this is minus 25. We have to write minus 25 here. Okay. Not minus 25, it is 25. 165 minus 140 is 25. So this is 25, correct. This is not 45, this is 25. So 25 by 400. Into the class interval, which is 3, you have just have to subtract these two. 3 plus the assumed mean, we took as assumed mean as 57. So this is 57.19 will come. The table shows the daily expenditure on food of 25 households in a locality. You have to find out the mean daily expenditure on a food by Sukabu method. So this is the daily expenditure. What we are going to do, add these two divide by 2, like this. Frequency is here. Now take the assumed mean 225, subtract each value by 225, right in this column, or for all. Now divide by the class interval, 150 minus 100 is 50. So divide all the values by 50, you get this column. Now multiply this four column with this column, corresponding value. You get FIUI, add this, this will be minus 7. Minus 7, what is the sigma F 25? Multiplied by the class interval, which is your class interval is what? 50. And then add you have to add 225. This is not this, this is x bar. So what we have to do? You just have to solve this, you'll get it as 211. 225 plus 50 into minus 729. This you have to do. Here to find out the concentration of sulfur dioxide SO2 in the air in parts per million. The data was collected for localities for 30 localities in a certain city and is presented below. We have to find out the mean concentration of sulfur dioxide in the air. Again, same thing. We'll add these two, divide by 2 so that we can get the mid value. So this is the mid value, 0.00 plus 0.04 by 2. So all these are the addition of lower and upper limit by 2. Frequency is given. Now take the assumed mean 0.14. Now subtract each value with 0.14. So you get this column. Now this column can be, this column has to be divided by the class interval, that is 0.04, because 0.04 minus 0.00 is 0.04. So you have to subtract this xi minus 0.14, all these value minus 0.14 divided by this one, you have to divide by 0.04. So you get this column. Now multiply these two columns, this column and this column. Each value, now add this, you get minus 31. Minus 31 by 30, that is sigma f. What is the h? That is 0.04. And you have to add the assumed mean, which is 0.14. So the concentration of sulfur dioxide will come as 0.099 ppm parts per million. A class teacher has the following absentee record of 40 students of a class for the whole term. Find the mean number of days a student was absent. So and again, we'll do 0 plus 6 by 2, 6 plus 10 by 2, that will come here. Now what you have to do here is you can take any assumed mean you can take. Say we are taking 16. Okay, so 3 minus 16, this is xi minus 16. So xi minus 16, 3 minus 16 is minus 30. Like this, all the values have to be subtracted by minus 16. Now you multiply this, or this is a class interval. The class interval we cannot take. Why? Because this is 6, this is 4, this is 14 minus 10, 4. So the differences or the class interval are not common. So we will not divide it by the class interval. We'll simply multiply this 11 with minus 13, 10 by minus 18. So whole of this column has to be multiplied by this column. So you get FIDI. Now add these value, you get minus 145. Minus 145 divided by 14, 40, and just add this 16, which is the assumed mean 16. You get 12.35. 12.38. So the mean number of days is 12.38 days for which a student was absent. So these are the table giving the literacy rate of 35 cities. Find the mean literacy rate. So here we'll add these two, divide by 2. So add these two, divide by 2, you get this column. Now take the assumed mean as 70, subtract all these values by 70, you get this column. Now multiply 55 minus 45, which is 10. So divide all the values by this. Xi minus 70 is already there. Xi minus 70 divided by 10. So you get this column. Multiply this column with this column. You get this column. Add this. This is minus 2 divided by 35 into h, which is what? Which is your 10. So multiply by 10 and add it with 70. Assuming you will get 69.43, which is the mean literacy rate.